We have come to the ascending climax, you say, of the program, and you want to know why this person will be taking the podium. You just heard Dr. Kanu announcing an admission number. If I got it right, 1555. You will understand better what that means. So it is my singular honor to invite a friend of this university, this institution, a stakeholder of this institution, and the mother of this nation, the first lady, Madam Fatima Madadio. Come.
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, retired Brigadier Julius Malabio, my most handsome and humble husband, our revered Paramount Chiefs, me paparem, gladi for siuna today. Honorable ministers here present, students, teachers, professors, doctors, everybody, Dr. Philip John Kanu, the man we make with there, Madam Josephine Jackson, the Edman. As Ayerini Edman, they speak English and begin for wonder. The Edman say, I mean, in Fatmata, but yes, you're right. Fatmata is Fatima. And I'm pleased that today you come in front of His Excellency and not only endorse Mr. Magari for being a university, but also endorse Josephine Jackson for be the MP we will represent you. Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, today I am here to talk to our parents, our mothers and fathers. I am here to talk to them because it is very important that our mothers and fathers understand the need of education in our country. Education is the only solution to a country's development. Education is the only way for a country to see light and continue through that light in any part of the world. When you have an educated nation, you definitely will have a developmental nation. Now we have a president who believes in education, a president who spends in education, a president who believes in the transformation of our country. If we talk about food safety, if we talk about the best hospital, if we talk about agriculture, if we talk about human capital development, all of that is possible when you have an educated nation. So on behalf of all the mothers of this nation, I want to say thank you to retired Brigadier Julius Malabio for paying, because we never understand waiting at the talk where you don't know I'm in how much it costs. But this now the one man where they pay for 2,500,000 school picking them school fees in this country. 2,500,000 school picking them. 2,500,000 school picking. That you need 20 national stadium for able to flop them picking them. For let we get a president where believe say 22% of we national GDP for go to a stadium full, to 40 stadium full of people for make them picking a day better. Your Excellency, You give me the task for go around and talk to constituency 110, and I don't go around. I go around and understand the problem for this constituency, and where I go around with the candidate where you put forward, when I Josephine Jackson, where they stand for the SLPP. You know, today I stand here not only as the First Lady of the Republic of Sierra Leone, but I believe for people where they follow waiting and they do. Last year, I become a student of the Mercy Magai. Last year, I signed publicly that I not only be a student of this school, but I will also contribute the little idea where I get when it comes to performing arts. I will become a lecturer. So I get a number called, my number now 1555. So His Excellency, I hope you understand the reason why Mercy Magai is so dear to me. And when you're not students in a college, and when you don't go to a point where you don't go to university, you won't just continue for then at university. Your Excellency, I beg. I know say you love me anyway, so I know the answer. I beg you, sir. The whole of constituency 109 and constituency 110. They want to let this place be a university. They want to let this place, the last 4 weeks where they go around, they want to let this place be a university for a few simple reasons. You don't need any form of a certificate for let you able for do tailoring. And when you get that certificate from me, Timagai, you don't become your own boss. You don't need to get a certificate for can enroll na ya for learn how for do fish processing. You are them fishermen in there. Yeah. The fishermen in there. I hope so they speak una waiting una tell me for tell His Excellency. Now fish processing, we not say. Thank you. I be one begin for say I saw Sally, so Mr. President will understand say me and Unana we get special language right now. I be long tell the honorable minister say let take her easy to now because the me and Unana we the role. Please sir, feed processing no need certificate. But when they can't get one of the biggest harbor in this country, when I under your leadership now we they get that one day na Black Johnson. And we go for need professional people that we go study for do food processing and fish packing. We get for need them people today. So the whole of this constituency from here round all the way to compound to PWD towards Waterloo, everybody they look forward for can learn naya for let them will be prepared for that new change when you they bring na this country. Your Excellency, the young woman them where they talk to around and they talk about soap making and this innovation. Like waiting because we decide not for call them, you know, handicraft and all of this, we call them innovation. Because this is the new change and the new dawn. The woman they want for Kanaya for land soap making and for you to put all them beautiful things away there before we are using their hands but not certificates. So, Your Excellency, that's not another thing. We don't need a certificate for let us learn how to do gara and daka and die. You only need your hand, your eye, and the motivation for doing. So, having this place as a place where they said go call home, it will be a great thing, not only for Sierra Leone, but for constituency 109 and 110. They also say the one for Kailan. Mechanics, car mechanics. Your Excellency, me and yourself, we know say boku mechanics in this country are now by the grace no more. If you don't touch you motor car, now God no more will protect you. So then, we can't get a place where Nayaden will can learn from scratch and get the right qualification. The right qualification so when they touch you motor car, you know say you are safe to be in that car. We not say my boyfriend that when the Okada riders say, the Keke riders say, them Pokuna then Saya, And not say, me man not the jealous who I call on my boyfriend then, because he not say, now he gets me. But this is very important, Your Excellency. The way where the Okada riders them and the Keke riders them, they ride now with city, they need proper training. They need a training where they not go only they do their job in a peaceful atmosphere, but they will also know the ethics of driving in the road of our city. So from this place, they will come and learn from scratch. Even in the United Kingdom, you know they go learn motor car, where you go to our land for drive, they know they say bring PhD certificate. Then they say can learn. Then they learn it from fresh. So that people here go Canada, they don't need none of them qualifications today, because now here they can't get the qualification. When they come out here, then they go and go serve this country and then become their own boss. We the woman then, we all know the importance of looking good, especially when you don't host with your man. You want to make sure say every time when your man wake up, when he see you, you there on top of your game. We get for land, forget woman they waste a bit. We get for land, forget woman them, and man them waste a bit for do we nails them, waste a bit for do pedicure, manicure, waste a bit do you makeup. Some people then they when they make up you look like say they take paintbrush, they paint your face. So but from here now, they will come learn all of them thing in the day. And then when they come out now, they will come without a certificate, but then they will leave with a certificate and they will become their own bosses. So these are the things them way this constituency go around then talk about. Of course, we know about the microcredit where everybody go they say they want, but I don't tell people them run the constituency. The best thing you can have in your house is to have an educated children. And then picking them there tomorrow, after they get all of them qualifications, say, yeah, I make one example to some parents the way I go to Kent. Before them build house for mother, be always pay their school fees. Then get for bills for their mama and their papa first. So we allow them let them go to school. Before them buy motor car for mother, be for saying that mother be pay me school fees. Now then mama and their papa first, they get for buy motor car for. So allow the kids to go to school. I even make an example. If they walk into a hospital today, mother be only done at the other bed, then mama or then papa live on at the other bed, then they pay their mama and then papa the hospital bill first before they say, now mother be only be paying the school fees. So the reason why I keep for make the example there, and for make sure you understand, see, when you begin go to school, where it better, where you don't learn something, it begin for and whatever, now you as the parents, now you the benefit first, before then think about mother bio. Because 2,500,000 people, now how many of them will even know who that's na mother bio by the time when they qualify? So please, Sierra Leone, we don't lucky forget a leader. We believe in education, and not only believe in them, but they also put in money into the education for make sure that we begin them better. Dear, now we take this opportunity and use them positively, because not to all countries they get luck forget mother being kind as a leader. You get president then. You can get a president. For votes, during the campaign I tell you now, for votes for president not the easy part. But for get a good president, now that's what they focus on. And mother Bio, the facts say, when the president is a good person, not to you is a member first. Any president where the member you pick in, now in let you. Any president where they protect you, Pekin, na in let you. Any president where believe in you, Pekin, na in let you. Because you not say, when that Pekin they better, now you your life they change first. The doctors them, where you get Pekin, where don't land, it in a hospital, you not say that Pekin, then you go for the men. Where you get lawyer, now you Pekin, you not say, now you then go for the be proud of, for say, yes, now you Pekin this. So, dear, when now we concentrate in making sure we begin and go to school. And that's now the tie way I make to every woman I am. Even when they ask for microcredit, I say, if you bring me a document where she'll say, you don't register, you begin at school. And I call that school, then say, yes, that begin there, then at school, and then they attend the way they're supposed to attend. We go make sure, say, they get the microcredit in. Because microcredit is done within 1 week. But when you picking don't go to school, he don't empower himself with knowledge. So God and this day, that one day forever. No political party no go pull on the picking head. No political party no go confuse the picking name. And I also be say to Unadia, this election on the 12th, not an election where we go for faith. Nobody no need for faith. Nobody no need for choke person. Nobody no need for kill person. Election, now vote you go vote. When you vote, if the party where the people they want na in win. And the one thing where I make law na understand, we all as politicians, then we all get speaking in. We all get speaking in. And for any politician, where they vote to you, he bring total pack, mega pack, pack, all them pack them. He can't forgive you picking. He can't forgive you picking. And then add Tramadol Panan. For let you picking Krishna this country. I beg. Tell that politician, say, yes, no problem. He picking the drinker, but bring the young picking, let we all drink. If the politician not come with in young picking, for let not drink then total pack them, then mega pack them, then other pack them. Tia, we not say no. We not need for fets. We not need for cost. All we need for do is go out and vote. And vote for the party where you not say. Now he get the direct access to His Excellency the President. Party will believe in His Excellency in agenda. The party will believe in Mother Beyond in agenda. The party will not say, in all the member in color clothes where he got for wear before he reached State House. The party will go wear any color clothes because he don't need for wear color for prove himself. He just need for make sure say the people then agenda. Now in your agenda, because Mother Beyond and the President will make sure say the people's agenda in Sierra Leone now the only agenda that they will work on. So Your Excellency, throughout this also, I make let them know say we, for when this place here become university, we will give scholarship to 50 picking them now this constituency for Kalan, whatever they want for land naya. 25 of them, it can be man and woman, but the other 25, it will strictly be woman then, within constituency 110. And that one, they all depend again, how the because the more we go to the people then, the more the registration just they add. Also, Your Excellency, I want to let you know, say, amen. Your Excellency, I want to let you know, say, Mr. Magai gets a hospital. This hospital here, not just for Mr. Magai's students then, but it has served this community. And where I come, I see the condition of the university. Now that make I been go to you, I mean the hospital. Now that make I go to you, I explain to you, say, we need for change the beddings in this place. So the structure where you give me, I want to let you know that I don't carry on. We don't bring 20 brand new beds then for the hospital, for the community naya, then go get the young place because the hospital they serve the community. I also go Laka self gets the Laka hospital. On Your Excellency, you will be surprised for no say Laka hospital gets one bed. So when they say that to me, I no say my job now for go around decide the way you not able to reach. Let we reach there, because now we are your foot soldiers then. Again, when I report to you, you say make I take care of that. We don't send 10 beds then for going to Laka Hospital for make sure say themselves go get their own beds then. Let bed not be the problem. So at this juncture, I want to thank you, Your Excellency, not only for being a great leader, but for inspiring us. You know, they say nothing other than this world was sweet. Where woman tin up for talk, let's say me man know they lie. When me man talk, he they do one. And now na do he they do and then he talk later. So I said thank you so very much.
We don't come to the climax of why we're there. We go take the cultural interlude after His Excellency where we go towards the commission in place. So we're not going to do that because we actually catch up with some other programs. I'll get the biggest honor for invite the first gentleman with Papa, the man we, as Dr. Kalu don't say, at every stage of this college in life, there has been a Julius Maada Bio. For let it transform from HCC to BED, it was under his leadership with the leading country, let me pioneer that. For let this college cantor to a university, what a coincidental blessing, now under HE President Julius Maada Bio. So it is my honor, the greatest honor for call on His Excellency the President, Brigadier Retired Dr. Julius Maada Bio, to take the podium.
Please sit down, please. Mr. Chairman, Madam First Lady, Honorable Ministers of Government, Members of Parliament, our revered Paramount Chiefs, the Principal, Mr. Magai College of Education and Technology, faculty and staff of MMCET, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Wonders never end. Wonders never end. 2 years ago, I kind of had not allowed myself for talking that good today. They say, I'm not fit enter Naya. Today, and I want canoe and deprive me of that opportunity. Today, my another canoe don't give me that same opportunity. Before we know that same canoe day, he don't explain it or diesel, most of which me don't know about. I go only say, Batine yo. Batine yo. Great things are happening in this country. Just last week, the APRM's very encouraging assessment follows a global recognition from the disease control, for the Center from Disease Control and World Health Organization. The CDC now an organization within the United States, and of course, we know about the World Health Organization, WHO. And their view is that CRO's response to COVID-19 has been nothing but outstanding. Say we need a better club than that for all of us. That means say what do they do? Great institutions around the world, they see what do they do inside this tiny country. We have kept case fatality ratio and infection rates very, very low. COVID-19 pandemic continues, however, to ravage and kill all over the world, as you know. So my best advice to all of us is to continue to adhere to healthcare directives and remind ourselves that it is our responsibility to keep one another safe. COVID see the, COVID the kill, and we need to take care, may COVID not kill we or we loved ones. Then. We may be a small nation, of course we are, but the world is praising us, and deservedly so. That is because we are doing a lot of things right under this leadership. From the response to COVID-19, to fight against corruption, governance, women's empowerment, the fight against SGBV, to education and more, we don't change the landscape. That narrative, it only changed. What we do, what we do, because we want to address vulnerabilities and poverty within the bigger context of our national development. Our medium-term aspiration as a nation is to transform our economy for national development. We not come for nothing. We want to make everything change. If waiting sleep don't do at this campus now, so everybody will make effort. Whether privately, in Mano, everybody will not get billions, but the little way they get, the same little where the other canoe they get, where they make here, 27 not it. Now the same little, this other canoe they get, see what they don't do. We believe, among other things, that a skilled and resourceful labor force can unlock rapid national development through relevant training in science, technology, and innovation. I have argued that Africa is lacking behind in development simply because it has not sufficiently invested in quality education and total workforce development. With the African youth board getting even bigger within a decade, income and national development disparities will widen even further. The youth mandate plenty all over, and they never plenty past three. If we not find way for men get the skills and knowledge necessary for make them be part and pursue and participate in government and other ways of life, that blessing they will turn to sweep away. So if the fourth industrial revolution and the future of global trade and investment is about automation, big data, artificial intelligence, advanced robotics, efficient machines, then our workforce of the future must be equipped with the requisite skills to participate meaningfully in that global economy. We always talk about Asia. Asia countries have strengthened their economies and lifted millions out of poverty because they have created the right skills to attract huge investments into their economies. The argument, therefore, is very simple. If we invest in workforce development and equip our future workers with the right skill set, we stand a greater chance of becoming a favorable destination for investment, a less poor and less vulnerable society, and a much developed nation. This is why we are investing in our youth. The what did Madam Bede talk about? I really want for more taken seriously. So Mammy the Hala said the ground dry. But when you can inside MMTC, you will see why the ground dry and but not dry now. Because what did them they use for soak? Who's I not supposed for soak? And then we they take that money they, and apply them appropriately. Yeah, not to my home. Yeah, not a place where I can sit down for enjoy. But yeah, I know say we brothers, we picking them where they can are. They acquire knowledge and skills. We will make them become useful to themselves, their family, and also this nation. So for me, everybody will vote for me, and even the one that will not vote for me, now see citizens of this country. Me aim now for make my this country go before. So what here they do is that place we saw go put money, we go get multiplier effect on the economy. Now there they put the money. That makes so Monday, when they say the place right now, we say it's Mapo. Then they look at say all salaries are paid on time. We they pay for 2.5 million kids around this country for make sure say everybody goes to school. You don't forget excuse why you know they go to school. And because we know say when they get that education, they, as how Madam Bede say, they're useful to themselves, their parents, they keep them, they sell them common, they distribute them in this nation. So, although it's difficult, 2.5 million, we pay over 80,000 teachers, and we pay them every month because we want quality education, because that's the only way that we will reduce poverty. Workforce development through basic training, reskilling and upskilling is a precursor for innovation, manufacturing, and for economic transformation. So our investment in education are guided by two key questions. And what are these? One, what skill sets will a productive Sierra need for the next 20 years? You see, we think ahead now. We don't lost for plenty in them in this country. But we no want no begin them lost. So we they prepare now for waiting we don't see before we. So the skills that we give them, if we make them become useful in the future, may not go you learn Greek and Roman culture, we come out, you not get time for work. So what skill sets will a productive Sierra need over the next 20 years? What skill set do we need to expand our economy? Every day, man is a job not the whole. Waiting not to government no more, they make job the day. Government in your now for create the policies, we go encourage entrepreneurship. We big company they come, investment they come. They ask you again. They need people there for work, but they need skilled people. People that will get something at their head, they will go to the enterprise then, and it will help them. These are the questions that have informed our policy on technical and vocational education in general and guided our thinking on transforming polytechs into technical universities. We acknowledge in the New Direction Manifesto the appalling state and neglect of technical and vocational education in Sierra Leone. From the lack of clarity about TVET's mission and missions to challenges with perceptions. First thing when you say can do technical education, people then keep say now fully full or you know able. No. We need it, especially if one for develop. All of we can have we use transport for camp. If you want to cast up, even for the slightest of problems, we all know something. We need one small mechanic where they can only talk something, then you continue. You need them kind of people that they, all the Okada, the way they move, they all get people that wait for Sabi, Master Sabi, where they make them, they keep going. So, what do they do is, we want to create universities, we will create the kind people that we will do them what they do. We accept in both the New Direction Manifesto and the medium-term national development plan that technical skills development is critical for improving infrastructure, manufacturing, healthcare, general public service delivery, and private service delivery. We believe that technical universities should help advance our strategic goal in the technical and vocational training sectors more vigorously. Students must be granted the opportunity to achieve the highest qualification in technical education from an accredited university. There must be a clear pathway from technical secondary education to degree level education and training, and that is the pathway we are trying to create. This removes a scourge of inferiority complex associated with polytechnics as an institution and create advanced career and training possibilities for our young people in this country. So what is the value of a technical university? One would argue then that an agricultural extension worker from a technical university who helps farmers triple their rice production is measurably more valuable for national development than a holder of a master's degree in Latin, coming from the best university in this country. We can also say that a diagnostic lab technician, a pre-K teacher, a water systems mechanic from a technical university is more critical for national development than a graduate with a PhD in classical music from the best university in the world. So upgrading a polytechnic to a technical university, therefore, diversifies tertiary level course offerings, broadens and deepens the value of relevant technical education for national development, and narrows the gap between workforce development and employer needs, and establishes the much needed parity in the tertiary education sector. Also, technical universities with predominant predominantly focus on Tibet courses, science, technology, and innovation. They will be practice-oriented, have smaller class sizes, and maintain more contact hours between students and lecturers and instructors. So there are very strong reasons to make for transforming polytechnics into technical universities. And I hope we can understand that as a nation. A number of very favorable developments, I repeat, favorable developments, now mean that we are closer to elevating polytechnics, technical universities, than we ever have before in the history of this nation. A lot of things that don't happen. As Nabiyeri, the principal, they talk, plenty of things that don't happen. And in the ministry too, we don't come closer to that realization. As an intentional government, we have considered 5 key elements to the process. We know they do things that no more. We don't they go be here for long. But now, when will they do anything, will they think why we want technical universities? We don't think thoroughly about that. And our place as leaders to make sure say we do the things that we're good for we now and for the future. As I've been saying, I can normally say, some people they're not good for themselves and they're not even good for this country. So we gotta be careful how we choose leadership in this country. First, for the overarching global question, what are the prospects for the success of an institution as a technical university? A series of questions I'm going to ask, and that is for the administration, but I will assure you that most of those questions have been thoroughly answered. What is the value and correlation of technical university curriculum to national development? What is the possibility that as a technical university, this institution can consistently support expanded post-training to entrepreneurship program? Second, are legal and procedural questions. Evidently, as a government, we have closely examined the enabling legal and regulatory requirements. The Draft Universities Act has been reviewed and approved by Cabinet, as it has already been said. It will soon be tabled in Parliament for debate and approval. I am informed that Tertiary Education Commission has concluded all due diligence checks and are giving the all clear, as you heard from the chairperson. Cabinet, I must say, is unambiguous about this. Meitei Magai College of Education and Technology is going to become Meitei Magai University of Education and Technology. Let me repeat, Meitei Magai College of Education and Technology is going to become Meitei Magai University of Education and Technology. And that goes to the power bank. The third question of institutional readiness, is this institution ready? And you must have had your questions, I mean, answered already from what the principal said. Has the curriculum been reviewed to ensure compliance with the National Quality Education Agenda? Can we track this institution's performance over a period of time? Is there demonstrated leadership at this institution that we aptly midwife that transition to a technical university? I think that has been emphatically answered here too. Do we have a critical mass of qualified lecturers in place to staff the technical university? I think we do. Must we start thinking about establishing and constituting administrative structures of the university and searching for substantive vice chancellor and principal, registrar, and other levels of university administrative staff? Fourth, there is a question of funding readiness. Are there sufficient funds to establish and pay for the operations of the university? Our government's investment in education leaves no doubt about why it is a priority. Finally, there is a question of infrastructure readiness. Do we have sufficient infrastructure for instruction, administration, utilities, and housing, and even more? It is in this area, too, that I must state how proud I am of Dr. Philip Kanu, and his team of dedicated staff for the tremendous progress they have made here at this institution with the support of my government and in other international partners. I have somebody to attest to what is happening at Mr. Magai, which is quite phenomenal. I approached an acquaintance of mine who works here some time back. I said, you've been working very hard as a lecturer. Do you mind to work in the public service now? He said, no. I said, are you sure? He said, yes, I'm not leaving. I said, why? He said, because I have a new leadership and I'm very optimistic about the future of the MMCET. So congratulations, Dr. Kanu, for being an exemplary leader. I hope others in other institutions will copy your example and will do their best, even against all odds. We have not given anything extra to him. Nothing extra, but he's transformed the physical look of this campus. And he's also, you can see and feel the cooperation with other staff. And that is what leadership is about. It's not just about cosmetic. It's about the people, the lecturers, and all the staff. And even with the students, you can see that there is strong cooperation among them. The refurbished Great Hall, the new staff complex, and the health center are all testament to my government's work to upgrade this institution to a technical university. And there is even more. The International Atomic Energy Agency has provided equipment and reagents to transform the science lab into a state-of-the-art lab. You see, now they are attracting great partners, partnering with great partners around the world to change the narrative. Lab staff are also being trained. Great things are happening on this campus. Funds have been secured under the Badia project to rehabilitate and expand the Godrich campus. Funds have been secured under the Enhanced Integrated Framework for Sustainable Tourism Development and Promotion Project. Funds have been secured through the National Tourist Board and implemented through the Ministry of Tourism and the Ministry of Trade for extensive reconstruction work at the Brookfields campus of this institution. Some of that funding will go towards reviewing the curriculum and training the staff, which is very, very important. Also at the Brookfields campus, the National Youth Commission has implemented the skills development project by providing huge supply of equipment for hospitality department at that campus and supporting capacity training of faculty members. The World Bank, through the Skills Development Fund, supervised by the Ministry of Technical and Higher Education, is also working closely to provide grants for upskilling staff in the same hospitality department. Government has provided initial funds to rehabilitate the Congo Cross campus. Discussion for matching grants from Skills Development Fund to support this rehabilitation are at an advanced stage at the Godrich campus. My government has provided funds for the rehabilitation of Great Hall, the health center, the college library, all the toilets in the student hostels, and for constructing a decent staff complex and peace amphitheater. Government has also worked with the principal and staff to purchase two new 16-seater Toyota Hiace buses. As you heard the principal say, from recorded history, nothing like that has been done in this place. But great things are happening, and more things will happen. This will serve the shuttle runs among the campuses. My government has also made available a 30-seater Toyota Costa bus to ferry students and faculty to internship sites and to support supervision of teaching practice placements. For security, CCTV cameras have been installed on all the three campuses, and a biometric attendance device has been installed to monitor staff and student attendance. I'll be done giving tell and say we need for Kopila in your own day, because everybody expressing me for the go run after a minister and work at the EU building. I said, no, with the user technology, we see you go impress your hand at the Sudana State House. I know that they're holding at the workplace. You know, the headmaster, you know, to headmaster, I'm not going to the wrong day. Adults there, you know, at the run up that building, and so they said they run at the other part for going to the inside here. So now we use technology for the case. Then we then our office pauper at the time. This institution was born out of the vision of Sir Mithi Magai, the first Prime Minister, to train teachers who would deliver quality education to our new nation. During the National Provisional Ruling Council, during our time, it became a degree-granting institution, as already stated. During the tenure of Dr. Ahmed Tijankaba, the institution was upgraded to polytechnic status in 2001. The hostels and the classrooms at the Ocean View were constructed under the SLPP, but our brothers transformed those lecture rooms to dwelling houses. What a disaster. Never again. They're not good for themselves, they're not good for this country. Those buildings must revert to for the purpose of which they were originally constructed, Mr. Principal. For all of these developments, the pattern speaks volumes. Human capital development and real transformation of the institution. From the vision of our founding fathers to now, one set of leaders who have shared a common ideology has cared most about transforming this institution. By now, this country could be convinced that there is a party that cares about people, not just cosmetic development. And not just one big road. Any big road we are built is for help change the lives of people. Like the Funkia Godrich Road. Yes, sir. Why? Because we get a lot of people in that community where they do fishing. The woman them, the boatman them, and everybody. Why would they put that there? Not for help them, for make them do them train, make them able and something, and take care of the people then. And especially the woman then, who don't they cater for all around. You know, I can joke say, we man them, who gets more money, when they send and go down first before we go to house. And so man can send and go down, say, nothing not enough for going to house again. So the woman then will help them. Me, na a he for she champion. Don't let me say the man they never vote for me next time. I just say the woman they best pass me. Because where woman they get, then they can't go to house. They must make sure they the pot boy also. but tell you some man in the, by the time they reach my house, all don't go down. Ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by thanking and congratulating the principal and the entire MMCET community, the Western Rural District community, friends and well-wishers of the MMCET for your kind invitation to be with you today. Like I say, the last time we attend Kokanaya to talk to the student and what he has stand for, amen and consider between the many, among the many parties where they contest, they say, Papa, you know go enter Naya. That is bad politics. That is not good. So we deprive the young people that we meet in Naya for listening to me. But of course, thanks be to the church up here, in Tunisia and Nakotoli, they go put this in Apantabia at Timap. I shall say plenty of the students that come in Naya. We turned the church to the political forum that evening. Now they have to map and talk, then I go. Well, you know, as God will have it, we are really, because we campaign and do everything, not only in great places, but in the church too. So they give me an opportunity for use the church, for talk to people there, and the great people of this country have. And next time, we will send a better message. Now we have another Kanu. We already know to SAPP. We got APC in there, but they have the right to this campus. They have the right to this campus. You know, they say, no, you know the answer. Come. The more we educate, the more we will lessen, reduce violence. I don't challenge everybody. I beget my manifesto and the manifesto copy today. We don't change nothing. It's printed and it's laid out in public. That is the social contract we are signed with this nation. Now they are signed, say, A, B, C to Z. Now the thing that that's what I will do for this country. I don't begin to do that. I'm not done yet. COVID don't come. You don't bother me, but we know the fair excuse. We still continue for make sure, say, waiting with permission in this country. We don't to lie government. Now for do. Waiting good for now. So the essence of education, now for make us get critical minds, now we're able to solve problems then. So when time comes, like how Madam Billy say, now we get the opportunity for talk to people then. Nobody not born inside party and in blood, now that's a party though. But when I give you the opportunity, no, we team up and talk. What do we get now in mind? Say we will do for the people of this country. When we stick to colors and not analyze what the people they say, whether they be wrong or not. So we reduce politics to tribalism, regionalism, and all the other isms. But I want to assure this country, say, we stand for the people. And that is why mine is a human capital development program for this country. Let's see the day for do. But me, they tell when I say, we feed the brain, we feed the belly, and then take care of the human being. The human being will be able to go find them for himself. Nobody know one for me. He just need for make sure he's healthy. He buy food, and you know, say food, the type of food, the way they make, he they get well, but he too, and you know, they see quick. And then if you start in here with quality education and skills, that human being, whether in a salon or in America, he will fend them for himself. Now that makes you the best thing we are able to give now. And we are not able to give some of them now, because we don't miss the opportunity, then we could give now all we are picking them and we not choose them people. So with the third thank you to everybody, we don't be part of the various projects that we will become commissioned today. I wish to assure you that we always be an advocate, an ambassador for technical universities and technical education in the Republic of Sierra Leone. Therefore gives me a great pride and pleasure to launch the Skills Development Fund valued at $3.5 billion and formally commission the series of infrastructural improvements that have already been highlighted here. I thank you all for your attention, and God bless this community.